right, or an athlete, you know. Don't sleep away in bed. Get up, go to class. I know that right now, because of the pandemic, it's been online. I'm on the Ritz and I'm back with another video. By the title below, you know exactly what this video is about. If you're new to my channel, welcome, and if you're not, welcome. Continue to follow my journey and follow me and my path to success, because guess what, I have started a cosmetic line. It's not official as yet, but I, you know, create an Instagram page so you guys can go over and follow my cosmetic page at Brittany_cosmetic. You can also follow my photography page at Brittany's_captions_ and my main page at Alanda Britt, same as my YouTube name. So you guys can follow, share, you know, tag me. And right now, at this point, I have this giveaway going on. So if you don't see that as yet, please run over to become a lucky winner. But yeah, so as I was saying, my video is about 5 tips for college students. These tips are tips that I've basically been using for the past 2 years. I don't use them. I'm not consistent. If you had watched my previous videos, I made one with 5 things that I need to change. And so if you want to hear the tips, you better
stay tuned, okay?
All right guys, so before I move on in my video, right, make sure to subscribe, make sure to comment, make sure to share my channel, okay? Thank you so much. So the first tip for college students is develop a routine. Actually, I have these written down in front of me because I'm not going to remember everything out of the tip of my head. So I had jotted down certain things to share with y'all. So the first thing I have is develop a routine. Like, you got to set yourself to wake up at a point in the morning. And you know, when you get up, for example, you decided to get up at 6 a.m. or 7 a.m. I normally get up like 4:30 or 4 o'clock for training, because I have training at 5 a.m. in the morning. So I get up, get prepared, you know, think positive, feeling energized, getting up at a specific time, thinking positive. You know that your entire day is going to be positive. I guarantee you that it's going to be positive. If you get up angry, negative, your entire day gonna be that way. You're gonna be angry at others, angry with yourself, not knowing why. So once you get up in a positive mood, the entire day is gonna be positive, okay? So structure your academic hours. Like, for students that are not athletic, right, or not athletes, you know, don't sleep away in bed. Get up, go to class. I know that right now, because of the pandemic, it's been online classes. Get up the same time as you would be going to class. Go online. Do your. I know, I'm speaking about myself. I know that sometimes for me, for example, I have a class like 10 o'clock. I get up 10 o'clock, go on the virtual call, and go back to sleep. This is after training, because I train like from 5 to about 9, and then I come to my dorm, take a shower, get a little nap, get up for class, and I would sleep during the class. But guess what, I'm still doing my work. But that's really a bad habit to do. Do not do that. Get up, go to class, listen, because it's a lot of things that you're missing when you go back to sleep. So get up, go to class, although it's virtual, engage in classes, right, and stuff like that. So that's my first tip. The second tip is focus on organization. And the reason why I say this is because organizing yourself is very, very important. If you have things scattered all around, you will be so uncomfortable, so angry, so frustrated because you don't have your things in order. So, and the thing too, when you're organized, you tend to bring that throughout your life. So you will, if you start now, by the time you go into the working world, you learn how to organize yourself, complete your task, and all that. The other thing is maintain your relationship. All the time you hear about networking. Network. That is a key word, network. Listen, I've been networking. I can call on so many people for so many things because I interact and network with people. Because you may never know, people that you meet in college can be your lifetime friends. I can guarantee you that. People you meet in college can be your lifetime friends. So maintain a good relationship with your classmate for accountability. The reason why I say this is that you can form study groups. All right, if you in a course that you don't understand, but there's somebody who knows what they're doing, ask that person, hey, can you help me with this? Can you show me how to do that? Make sure you keep a positive relationship with your classmates, okay? Share ideas. Oftentimes in college, you are going to be in a lot of group works, right? Me personally, I don't like group works because I feel like when I get my work to do, I need to do it and get over with. When you're in a group work, oh my gosh, you have to be texting, reminding, telling them, all right, you need to do this, blah, blah, blah. Sometimes they don't do it and you suffer also because at the end of the day, it's a group work. It's not a one person thing, it's a group. So you have to know how to work in groups, right? There is no high in teams, all right? And in the working world, you also have to work in groups. You have to work with a team. So I also want to say, if you're in a group for an assignment, majority of the time, I am the leader. Because listen, I don't care if I have to do all the work. As long as I get my grade, that's fine, right? So if you want me to be the leader, fine. You know what the thing is too? Sometimes when you're the leader, you do nothing because all you gotta do is tell that person what to do and then ensure that they do it and you have nothing to do, all right? So I know a lot of persons out there be running from leadership roles and all that, but the joke about it, the ironic thing about it is that at the end of the day, you're the leader, but you don't do anything. All right, just like if a person was the boss and have employees, the boss would do much, but the employees would. All right, but I'm not gonna speak on that no more. Maintain a positive relationship with your professors, because at the end of the day, you can get advice from professors. I mean, I'm not talking like some thing that won't benefit you, but something that will benefit you. Because since I've been in college, I had to receive a lot of advice from professors. Because they have set me on a good path. All right, the fourth thing is break works into small particles. What I mean by this is that your classwork should be done in class and your homework should be at home. Whether you're staying at home or in your dorm, those works are different works. Do not tell yourself, oh, I'm not gonna do this work in class, I'm gonna wait until my dorm or when I go back home, because you're just being lazy. And then when you do that, it's a bunch of work on you again. It happens to me before, so I know exactly what I'm talking about, all right? Sometimes I'm in class, I'm like, when I go home, I'll just do this. And then when I go home, I forgot everything the teacher said and then I can't do it. But if I had done it in class while she's speaking, I could have done my work. But I get you all that. I get you all that because, you know, that's why I say maintain good relationships, because at the end of the day, I hacked one of my classmates. Like, can you send me a note? I'm like, okay, I'll take a picture and send you. And I return the favor anytime somebody wants. Like, I don't care. Like, if you want help, I'm here to help you. Because at the end of the day, that's my blessing, okay? Helping someone that's in need is my blessing. All right, the fifth thing is parasympathize yourself. It's your body, mind, and soul. All right, don't be so hard on yourself. It's a stressful time right now with COVID and all that. I know personally, I've been stressed out. Like, you see my nails, they're growing back now, but when I was last semester, I used to bite them all the time, and I know that's because of stress, because I have so much to do. And in one of my other videos, I'm gonna tell you what exactly I've been doing at school, like the programs that I'm in and all that, and the type of work I have to do. But as I was saying, be kind to yourself, all right? Do not overwork yourself. Sometimes my hand be like this. That's my nerves, I know. But I try not to be so hard on myself, because at the end of the day, if I'm stressed, then my brain is not working properly, and then I can't do what I have to do. Nourish yourself, eat right, sleep when you're supposed to sleep, stretch, exercise. I'm always exercising. Every day I'm exercising, every day. And that's because I'm on track. But if I wasn't on track, if I wasn't an athlete, I would still exercise, all right? Because at the end of the day, all this is what makes me up. All this is what keeps me going. Can somebody tell me, you always hear this saying, eat before you go to school. Eat, your breakfast is the healthiest meal of the day, because that's what keeps you going. That's where the nutrients coming from. That's where your energy coming from. For me, if I'm doing an exam and I don't eat, if I'm doing a schoolwork and I don't eat before, my head hurts. Nothing is staying in my head. It's happened to me so much time that I'm so used to it by now. But it's not good. So as I was saying, nourish yourself. Those are the five tips that I have. And I hope it helped you if you're planning to go into college or if you're already in college. Those are the things that keeps me going. Those are five tips that keeps me going. So yeah, that's the end of my video. I know I'm a long talk. I love to talk. And I know that I speak fast. But you will understand what I am saying, all right? So remember, guys, remember, do like this, do like that, and the subscription button for me, turn on the notification bell, all right? So when I drop another video, you know to come over and watch, all right? Make sure you subscribe. I can't say this enough. I cannot emphasize on this enough. And tell a friend, okay? Tell a friend to tell a friend. And make sure you go over to my Instagram page and follow the instructions to win some giveaways. That rhyme, don't it? I know. All right, bye. Mwah.